सोनिया तिवारी फ्रॉम द डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ कम्युनिटी मेडिसिन अरविंदो मेडिकल कॉलेज इंदौर. सो इन दिस चैप्टर वी आर गोइंग टू कवर ओनली द इम्पॉर्टेंट पॉइंट्स एंड द शॉर्ट नोट्स विच आर आस्क्ड. राइट नाउ वी विल स्टार्ट विद द डेफिनेशन ऑफ व्हाट इज कॉल्ड द पॉपुलेशन जेनेटिक्स. सो स्टडी ऑफ प्रिसाइज जेनेटिक कंपोजिशन ऑफ द पॉपुलेशन and the various factors which determine the incidence of inherited traits in them. Now in the first slide itself they denote what are the preventive and social measures for the genetic disorders. So as we all know that we all have studied in the second chapter, that is the levels of prevention, the modes of intervention, levels everybody know, the primordial, primary, secondary and tertiary. With the help of levels of prevention, you all know the modes of intervention also. The modes of intervention, they denote health promotion, specific protection, early diagnosis and treatment, disability limitation, and last but not the least is rehabilitation. I hope everybody by this time knows about the second chapter, levels and modes of intervention. So this slide you can clearly see, it says what are the preventive and social measures for any kind of genetic disorders. So here only they say health promotion, specific protection, early diagnosis and treatment and rehabilitation. Only thing in genetic disorder, the fourth intervention, that is the disability limitation, is not here. Rest all the four are here. Now what inside this, what else we are going to remember is, you can see in the health promotion it is written about eugenics, euthenics, genetic counseling, consanguineous and late marriages. And early diagnosis and treatment means what? You have to detect the genetic carriers, you have to do the prenatal diagnosis, the screening of newborn and recognition of the preclinical cases. Now coming to the next slide, which says about the classification of genetic disorders. Now this is important for your Viva point of view, and one thing I know that many of us already know about these disorders. Okay, so we are just going to brush up and we are going to move forward because we have to cover many important chapters far away. Okay, so they are divided into three categories, that is the chromosomal abnormalities, the unifactorial and the multifactorial disorders. Now chromosomals everybody knows, just I am going to enumerate and I hope you will recognize it: relating to sex chromosome, Klinefelter syndrome, XYY, Turner syndrome, super females, and relating to autosomal, that is the Mongolism or the Down syndrome. Now coming to the autosomal dominant traits, in this slide you can see example of each category we are going to see. So just one or two examples for each one you can remember, that is quite enough. So autosomal dominant trait means what? Neurofibromatosis, ABO blood group system, polycystic kidney and the retinoblastoma. Then autosomal recessive traits, you can see that fibrocystic disease of the pancreas, phenylketonuria, cystic fibrosis and galactosemia. And recessive sex link traits will include your G6PD deficiency, your hemophilia, retinitis pigmentosa and your color blindness. And last is dominant X-linked traits will include vitamin D resistant rickets, blood group and familial hyperphosphatemia. Okay, now we are coming to advances in the molecular genetics. This question is asked in the UG examination once or twice. So I am just enumerating the points, that what are the advances in the molecular genetics, and you have to describe all the points in short. So there are four to five advances. Okay, here we are saying about four, some places five are also given. So first is your DNA technology, second is the gene therapy, third is the human genome project, and the fourth is human genome diversity project. Okay, so 4 points, again I am enumerating the advances in molecular genetics, that is the DNA technology, the gene therapy, the human genome project and the human genome diversity project. Now coming to the third slide, which says about the health promotional measures, which I already told you, we are going to focus on what is eugenics, what is euthenics, as it is always asked in the short note. Eugenics means the science which aims to improve the genetic endowment of the human population, right? Now there are two types of eugenics, that is the negative eugenics as well as the positive eugenics. Now negative eugenics means what happens is that Hitler sought to improve German race by killing the weak and the defective. Nobody would approve such a measure to improve human race, right? You cannot always kill the low IQ people and low caste people, or whether it is they are weak or defective, you cannot always dominate over the lower ones, right? That kind of race cannot be produced. So it is not practical. Therefore, aim of negative eugenics to reduce the frequency of heredity disease. So it is better that these kind of people, they should not have marriage, and in future they should not have certain types of disease. And if they are having disease, they should not produce children, because children will have the heredity disease. So negative eugenics says what? You have to kill the weak and the defective, and you have to produce always a good category people, but that is practically never ever possible. Then we come to positive eugenics, which improves the genetic composition of population by encouraging carriers of desirable genotypes to assure the abundant burden of parenthood. This is also difficult. It is difficult because of two reasons. First is what? Majority of the socially valuable traits, that is intelligence and positive character, they are not inherited in a simple way in your blood group. That is, if your parents are intelligent, if they are having positive character, it is very difficult that the child will always have the same character. Second important point is what? We cannot determine in the antenatal period or before delivery that what genes are transferred to the child. So this positive endowment is also difficult. So this is about the eugenics. Again, I am repeating that you have to improve your genetic endowment, right? There are two types of eugenics, that is negative as well as the positive. Negative says that you have to kill the weak and the defective, whereas positive says means what? Transfer of positive characters like intelligence, etc., to your coming generation. But this is difficult because of two reasons. One is that you cannot determine what genes are transferred to your child, and secondly, whatever intelligence factor you are having, whatever IQ you are having, whatever positive character you are having, that is not easily transferred to the child. We don't know in what kind of environment you are living. Now coming to the next important definition, that is euthenics. Eugenics. So euthenics means what? You have to improve the genotype of no use unless assessed to suitable environment. So when you are improving the environment, right, to produce positive situation, that kind of science is known as the euthenics, right? Please don't get confused. Eugenic, the word is saying that the genes which you are transferring, we are talking about that. Eugenics means what? The environmental factors you are going to improve, like a person who is having low IQ, right? So if you bring that person to a positive environment, to a good environment, the IQ is definitely going to raise, right? So eugenics means what? You are going to improve the environment, and then we are going to move forward, right? Third one, coming to the third one, that is the genetic counseling. Genetic counseling is of two types, that is prospective as well as the retrospective. Prospective means what? For true prevention of the disease, you have to identify the heterogeneous individuals for any particular defect, screening and explaining them the risk of having affected children. And if heterozygous marriage prevented or reduced, it will produce the chances of having birth to affected children, that will also decrease gradually. Okay, so true prevention of disease is the prospective. The example of prospective genetic counseling is what? Sickle cell anemia and thalassemia. Now coming to the next one, that is the retrospective genetic counseling. Retrospective means what? That heredity disorder is already there in the family. Okay, so genetic advice was chiefly sought in connection with congenital abnormalities like mental retardation, psychiatric illness, inborn errors of metabolism. Now, one important line which I am going to read and you all have to listen, that WHO recommends establishment of genetic counseling centers in sufficient numbers in the regions where infectious and nutritional disorders have been brought under control and areas where the genetic disorders have been constituted as a serious public health problem. And the example is sickle cell anemia and thalassemia. I hope you understand the difference. Prospective genetic counseling means what? True prevention of the disease. That is, you are preventing the disease. The disease has not occurred in the family. Okay. So, you are creating positive environment. Right. So, that is prospective. And retrospective means the heredity disorder has already occurred in the family. And now what you are going to do? You are going to prevent their marriages. You are going to prevent them having the children, etc. Now, other genetic measures which are there are consanguineous marriage and late marriage. Consanguineous marriage, I hope everybody knows, when blood relatives marry each other, there is increased risk of offspring of traits controlled by recessive genes and those determined by the polygenes. The examples of the consanguineous marriages disease are albinism, alkaptonuria, filial ketonuria. Late marriages, if they are done, and late children, they can have trisomy 21 or mongolism. Now, last point was early diagnosis and treatment. Early diagnosis of treatment includes detection of genetic carriers, that is especially the inborn errors of metabolism, the female carriers of Duchenne type muscular dystrophy. X-linked disorder can be detected by increased level of serum creatinine kinase. Now, prenatal diagnosis, you have amniocentesis in early pregnancy, that is 14 to 16 weeks, for the conditions associated with chromosomal abnormalities like Down syndrome, inborn error of metabolism, galactosemia. Now, what are the indications? In this slide, we are going to see what are the indications of prenatal diagnosis. So, for indications, as you can see in the slide, I have written A, B, C, D. A means what? Advanced maternal age. B is the biochemical disorder. C is the congenital anomaly. And D is the defect. That is screening for neural tube defect. The method which you are going to use is what? Cytogenetics, amniocentesis, protein assay and DNA diagnosis, the USG, fetoscopy and maternal serum, alpha fetoprotein and chorionic gonadotropin hormone. Okay, now coming to amniocentesis, that is estimation of the amniotic fluid for chromosomal abnormalities as early as 14th week of pregnancy. Now, the criteria for this is what? Mother's age should be more than 35 years, the parents with one child with Down syndrome, parents with chromosomal translocation, parents with child with metabolic defect, and family history of sex-linked genetic disorder. Now, screening of the newborn infant, that is the sex chromosome abnormalities, congenital dislocation of the hip, phenylketonuria, congenital hypothyroidism, sickle cell disease, cystic fibrosis, G6PD deficiency. And last is what? That is recognizing preclinical cases. Example, heterozygous for your phenylketonuria, they can be detected by phenylalanine tolerance test or simple examination of sugar, okay, after morning breakfast, that is good enough for detection of the diabetes. So this was all about the chapter and I hope you understand it, though it is very little tricky chapter, but a few questions are asked. First, you have to know about the definition. Second point, you have to do the classification. Then you have to define the certain diseases. Then what are the advances in the molecular genetics? Then something about the preventive measures. What can be done for these prevention of disease? So they are nothing but they are your what? Modes of intervention, right? Only disability limitation is not there. Otherwise, specific protection, early diagnosis and treatment. Okay, then your disability limitation is not there. Then rehabilitation and your health promote, other health promotive measures all come under this. And you have to focus what is eugenics, what is euthenics, what are the environmental measures, right? Eugenics means what? Means we talk about positive eugenics and negative eugenics, right? Then in euthenics means you are going to change and create a good environment so that everything becomes positive and you can prevent certain kind of diseases. And last is what? Genetic counseling, that is prospective and retrospective. So prospective, what you can say is true prevention of disease, whereas retrospective means hereditary disease has already occurred in the family. And last but not the least is your amniocentesis. Just remember a few points of that. I hope you understand the chapters, this chapter, and these are your MCQs. Please solve them sincerely and do check the answers at the end. Thank you.